This is the 11th Hour. With news and commentary for King James Bible believers, here's Greg Miller.
We get a constant barrage of email challenging us for our teaching that Jesus could appear in the sky at any moment to rapture his church out of this world before the Great Tribulation period. Many of these attacks are condescending, and others are just plain vicious. Well, this report is simply a response to those of you who mock and harass those of us who have not lost our hope in the rapture of the church. While you're busy trying to rob others of their hope and claiming that you believe that you are going to go through the tribulation period, I have come to a firm conviction about you. Bottom line, I don't believe that you don't believe the pre-trib rapture. Jesus said, "Wherefore by their fruits ye shall know them." That is why I repeat, I do not believe that you don't believe in the pre-trib rapture. Why? Your profession rings hollow because your actions don't measure up. So here we go. Here is just a sampling of what you are about to face if you really were going to have to go through the Great Tribulation. Isaiah 13, 6 and 7 says, "Howl ye, for the day of the Lord is at hand. It shall come as a destruction from the Almighty. Therefore shall all hands be faint, and every man's heart shall melt." Every man's heart shall melt. That includes you. And since you claim to be a believer in God's book, you should already be suffering from heart failure, since you know good and well that what the Bible says about the tribulation period is true. Isaiah 13:9 says, "Behold, the day of the Lord cometh, cruel, both with wrath and fierce anger, to lay the land desolate, and he shall destroy the sinners thereof out of it." It says he will lay the land desolate. That includes the land where you live. Isaiah 13, 10, 11 says, "For the stars of heaven and the constellations thereof shall not give their light. The sun shall be darkened in his going forth, and the moon shall not cause her light to shine. And I will punish the world for their evil, and the wicked for their iniquity. And I will cause the arrogancy of the proud to cease, and will lay low the haughtiness of the terrible." You live in a town or a city? You haven't gone off to some remote location? You don't have an above-the-ground concrete bunker with steel-reinforced walls and roof? You don't have a plan for radiation poisoning fallout? You don't have multiple guns and thousands of rounds of ammo? You don't have enough food and water for 1,260 days? And you want me to believe that you really think you're about to hit this Great Tribulation period? I think you're lying to yourself. Isaiah 13:13 says, "Therefore I will shake the heavens, and the earth shall remove out of her place, in the wrath of the Lord of hosts, and in the day of his fierce anger." You believe that, you've got time to play on the internet? Isaiah 13, 15, and 16 says, "Everyone that is found shall be thrust through, and everyone that is joined unto them shall fall by the sword. Their children also shall be dashed to pieces before their eyes. Their houses shall be spoiled, and their wives ravished." And you want me to believe that you believe that you're about to enter this Great Tribulation where they will take your children and break their bones and kill them as you watch. And you men think you're going to enter this time where your wives will be raped as you watch. I don't believe you. If you really believe that, you wouldn't be playing games on Facebook and watching videos of cute little kittens and going to the movies and attending sporting events. You'd be preparing yourself and your family. What I think is that deep down inside, you do know that the pre-trib rapture is true. And you know, whether you believe it or not, you'll be taken when it happens. But most of you post-tribbers don't have the guts to stand the mockery and the ridicule of believing this crazy stuff in the Bible about the rapture before the Great Tribulation. So this way you can have your cake and eat it too. You can pretend to be a big, brave soul who's ready to face the tribulation, but your actions speak much louder than your words. Now, a lot of you claim that you think God is going to spare you because you're a believer. Well, that's not what the Bible says. If you end up in the Great Tribulation period, you'll most likely end up dead. Here's a few passages. Daniel 7:25, speaking of the Antichrist, says, "And he shall speak great words against the Most High, and shall wear out the saints of the Most High." If that were you, doesn't say you're going to survive. Revelation 6:1, "And white robes were given unto every one of them, and it was said unto them that they should rest yet for a little season, until their fellow servants also and their brethren that should be killed as they were, should be fulfilled." The Great Tribulation period is a time in which believers are slaughtered. Revelation 13:7 says, "And it was given unto him to make war with the saints and to overcome them, and power was given him over all kindreds and tongues and nations." And chapter 20, verse 4 of Revelation says, "And I saw thrones, and they sat upon them, and judgment was given unto them. And I saw the souls of them that were beheaded for the witness of Jesus and for the word of God, and which had not worshipped the beast, neither his image, neither had received his mark upon their foreheads or in their hands. And they lived and reigned with Christ 1,000 years. If you're going through the tribulation, you're going into a time when nearly all believers are killed. The children die. The women are raped. Jesus described this time as in Matthew 24:21, "For then shall be great tribulation, such as was not since the beginning of the world to this time, no, nor ever shall be." Now let's just do a basic overview of what you're going to face if you really believe you're going through this great tribulation period. For example, when the fourth seal is broken, 1/4 of the world's population will be eliminated. You do the math, that's 1.7 billion people plus. The sixth trumpet, another 1/3 of those remaining will die, and that will be another 1.75 plus billion. I say plus because we're adding 100 and some thousand people a day. So that number is going to go up from today for as long as it takes before this happens. So the world's population is going to drop. If it were to start in 3.5 years, who knows how big this number would be. But if it were to start today, it would drop from 7 billion to 4 billion, just like that. And that doesn't include all those who die under these other judgments, the four horsemen of the apocalypse in Revelation 6. The first trumpet, all the grass will be burned up, and a third of the trees will burn up. Wormwood hits with the third trumpet, and a third of the rivers and streams are poisoned. You have the Battle of Armageddon, where 200 million will die at least. And the blood will flow up to the horse's bridle. Now at this point alone, we are looking at the death of nearly 5 billion people, and only about 2 billion remaining on the earth, if it were to start today. And you people sitting around playing your little Facebook games and watching your cute little videos and sports and movies and all the stuff you do all day long, and you want me to believe that you really think you're going to go through this. And I'm not done yet. The second bowl, the sea turns to blood and all the fish die, and it'll cause other people to die. The third bowl, rivers and fountains become blood. More people die. The fourth bowl, the heat of the sun scorches men, covering them with boils. People will die. The devastation of a globally destructive earthquake in Revelation 16:18. Earthquakes all over the world like it had never been seen before. You can't buy, sell, or trade without the mark. The bottom has dropped out of a global economy that has lost more than 5 billion paying customers. And those who can buy, sell, or trade? Revelation 13, 15 through 18 says, and he had the power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. So more die. And he causeth all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand and in their foreheads, and that no man might buy or sell, save he that had the mark, or the name of the beast, or the number of his name. You think it's bad now not having health care? There's no health care during this time, and people are going to die because they can't even get to a hospital and pay the doctor. And they're going to die because they can't eat. Diabetics will die because they won't be able to control their sugar. And here is wisdom. Let him that hath wisdom, let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man, and his number is 666. And you want me to believe, when you say that you don't believe in this pre-trib rapture, and you believe you're going through all of this, while you're playing on the internet and doing all these things, writing us all these letters, trying to convince us how wrong we are, and you've got time to argue, I don't believe you.
4-year-old Riyati Binti Sapubi was beheaded by a single blow of sword earlier this month. Saudi officials then dangled her corpse from a helicopter to make sure the public could see the grotesque result of the execution.
Revelation 9:6, and in those days shall men seek death and shall not find it, and shall desire to die, and death shall flee from them. It's a time of zombies. And you think you're going through that, but you got time to waste. You're not prepared. I haven't met a single person yet that's prepared not to go through this. I don't believe that you don't believe in the pre-trib rapture. Your works suggest otherwise. I will continue looking for that blessed hope and the glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior, Jesus Christ. For God hath not appointed us to wrath, but to obtain salvation by our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us, that whether we wake or sleep, we should live together with Him. Amen. Wherefore, comfort yourselves together, and edify one another, even as also ye do.